إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير هدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار إخوة الإسلام عباد الله Imam Malik, Imam Dar al-Hijra, he narrates the statement of al-Khalifa or the Khalifa Umar ibn Abdul Aziz, in which he states, Sanna Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, wa wulatu al-amri min ba'dihi sunanin, al-akhdu biha, i'tisamu bi kitabillah, wa kuwatu ala deenillah. Umar ibn Abdul Aziz, he states that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam and his successors, yani the khulafa that came after him, they legislated laws. So whoever adopts them, then he is clinging to the Book of Allah and is strengthened upon the Deen of Allah. ليس لأحد تبديلها ولا تغييرها ولا النذر في أمر خالفها. And it is not for anyone to attempt to change these things or to look at any affair that opposes it. فمن اهتدى بها فهو المهتدي وَمَنْ اسْتَنْصَرَ بِهَا فَهُوَ الْمَنْصُورِ. And so whoever is led by it, then he is upon guidance. And whoever seeks support from it, then he is aided. وَمَنْ تَرَكَهَا وَاتَّبِعْ غَيْرُ سَبِيلِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ وَاللَّهُ اللَّهُ مَا تَوَلَّى وَأَصْلَاهُ جَهَنَّمَ وَسَاءَتْ مَصِيرًا. But whoever abandons it and follows a way other than that of the believers, yani the first believers, the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he follows other than their way, then Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala will leave him on the path in which he has chosen, and he will burn him in the fire. What an evil destination. What an evil destination. This particular statement from the Khalifa Umar ibn Abdul Aziz, rahmatullahi ta'ala alayh, is highlighting for the Muslims the prophetic methodology, al-minhaj al-nubuwah, the prophetic methodology that is incumbent upon every Muslim to be upon. that is incumbent upon every Muslim to traverse upon, regardless of what day and time or land that we live in. And it is this methodology that is based off the revelation of the Quran and the Sunnah. As we see, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he states in the hadith of Al-Irbad ibn Sariyah, which is collected by Abu Dawood in his Sunan, likewise by Ibn Majah in his Sunan, likewise by At-Tirmidhi fi Jami'ihi, where the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam he states, فَإِنَّهُ مَنْ يَعِيشْ مِنْكُمْ فَإِنَّهُ مَنْ يَعِيشْ مِنْكُمْ بَعْدِي فَسَيَرَى اخْتِلَافٍ كَثِيرًا فَعَلَيْكُمْ بِسُنَّتِي وَسُنَّةِ الْخُلَفَاءِ الرَّاشِدِينَ الْمَهْدِيِّينَ تَمَسَّقُوا بِهَا وَعَضُّوا عَلَيْهَا بِالنَّوَاجِذِ. That whoever from amongst you all lives long, then he will see an abundance of differing. So upon you is my sunnah and the sunnah of my rightly guided successors. Cling to it and bite onto it with your molar teeth. This is what is contained in the two aspects of revelation that Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala revealed to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the Quran and the Sunnah. And this is what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam taught these two to the people, these two yani revelations that was revealed to him. As Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala he says, wa anzala Allahu alayka al-kitaba wal hikma وَعَلَّمَكَ مَا لَمْ تَكُنْ تَعْلَمْ وَكَانَ فَضْلُ اللَّهِ عَلَيْكَ عَظِيمًا. Indeed, Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, He has revealed to you, He has sent down to you the book and the wisdom. The book and the wisdom. The book and the wisdom. And He has taught you that which you know not. And indeed, Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala's favor upon you is tremendous. And Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, He says, هُوَ الَّذِي بَعْثَ فِي الْأُمِّيِّينَ رَسُولًا مِّنْهُمْ يَتْلُوا عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتِهِ وَيُزَكِّيهِمْ وَيُعَلِّمُهُمُ الْكِتَابَ وَالْحِكْمَةِ وَإِنْ كَانُوا مِنْ قَبْلُ لَفِي ضَلَالٍ مُّبِينٍ. It is He who has sent to the unlettered people a messenger from amongst them, reciting to them His verses, purifying them, and teaching them the book and the wisdom. And teaching them the book and the wisdom. And indeed, they were in, before that, they were in manifest loss or misguidance. Ikhwatul Islam ya ibadallah, the scholars from the time of the companions to this very day, they state that al-kitab hu al-Qur'an wa sunnah wa al-hikmah hi al-sunnah. That the book, it is the Qur'an, and this wisdom that was likewise revealed to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that which he taught to the people, it is the sunnah. And thus it is incumbent upon us to follow the revelation that has been revealed to us. As Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala says, اتبعوا ما أنزل إليكم من ربكم ولا تتبعوا من دونه أولياء قليلا ما تذكرون. And follow that which has been revealed to you from your Lord. And do not follow what is besides that from amongst those that are considered helpers of the shaitan, calling you to that which will lead you astray from this path. And then Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala states, and only a minority would take heed. Only a minority from amongst the people would take heed. Ikhwatul Islam ya ibadallah, this is the prophetic methodology that the Muslims should traverse upon. That when times of differing occur and mishaps are befalling the Muslims, then we follow the revelation that has been revealed to us. And do not look to other means and other ways in order to establish what is halal and what is haram. And the reality is only a minority from amongst the Muslims would take heed as it relates to this. And unfortunately from the deviant ways that an abundance of us handle these type or approach these types of affairs is that we look to what the majority say. We look to what the majority are upon. Yet and still what the majority say and the majority do is not a hujjah or a proof in Islam. As Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, He states, وَإِن تُطِعْ أَكْثَرَ مَنْ فِي الْأَرْضِ يُذِلُّكَ عَنْ سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ إِن يَتَّبِعُونَ إِلَّا الظَّنَّ وَإِنْ هُمْ إِلَّا يَخْرُصُونَ. If you were to follow or obey the majority of mankind, the majority of the people, then it would lead you astray from Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala's path. And they only follow conjecture, and indeed they have it within their speech inconsistencies. Inconsistencies, ya ibadallah. Imam al-Shawkani, rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi, he stays commenting on this verse. أَخْبَرَهُ اللَّهُ سُبْحَانَهُ بِأَنَّ إِذَا رَامَ طَائِفَةٌ أَكْثَرَ مِنْ فِي الْأَرْضِ أَضَلُّوهُ لِأَنَّ الْحَقِّ لَا يَكُونُ إِلَّا بِيَدِ الْأَقَلِّينَ وَهُمُ الطَّائِفَةُ الَّتِي لَا تَزَالُ عَلَى الْحَقِّ وَلَا يَدُرُّهَا خِلَافُ مَنْ يُخَالِفُهَا كَمَا ثَبِتَ ذَلِكَ عَنْ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ. Imam al-Shawkani, when commenting on this particular verse, he states that the glorified, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, the glorified, he informs and his messenger and the people that if a group of people were to look to the majority of mankind, then they would be led astray. And that is because the truth, it is only in the hands of the minority, not in the majority. And they are the group to whom which would not cease to be upon the truth and would not be harmed by those that stand in opposition to them, as it is authentically attributed to the Prophet ﷺ. As it is authentically attributed to the Prophet ﷺ. For this reason, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, He says, ثُمَّ جَعَلْنَاكَ عَلَى شَرِيَّةٍ مِّنَ الْأَمْرِ فَاتَّبِئْهَا وَلَا تَتَّبِئْ أَحْوَاءَ الَّذِينَ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ. And we have placed you on a legislation from the command, so follow it, and do not follow the desires of those that know not. Taking the majority as the yardstick, as the foundation, what they say, what they make halal, what they make haram, is nothing more than following the desires of those that know not. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. الله تبارك وتعالى says in his noble book, ألم ترى إلى الذين يزعمون أنهم آمنوا بما أنزل إليكم وما أنزل من قبلكم يريدون أن يتحاكموا إلى الطاغوت وقد أمروا أن يكفروا به وَيُرِيدُ الشَّيْطَانُ أَنْ يُضِلَّهُمْ ضَلَالًا بَعِيدًا. Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, He states, have you not seen those that claim that they believe in that which has been revealed to you, and they believe in that which has been revealed to those that came before you from amongst the prophets and messengers? Yet they desire, they yearn to or strive to seek judgments from other from other than Allah, from the Taghut, while they have been commanded to disbelieve therein. And the shaitan only wishes or desires to lead an individual into manifest misguidance or far astray. Ibn Kathir, rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi, he states, commenting on this verse, فَإِنَّهَا ذَمَّةٌ لِمَنْ عَدَلَ عَنِ الْكِتَابِ وَالسُّنَّةِ. He states that it is censoring those that stray away from the book and the sunnah, ويتحاكموا إلى ما سواهما من الباطل. And they seek judgment and other than the Kitab and the Sunnah, يعني that which is based off falsehood, like seeking a judgment in the majority. The majority says this is halal. The majority says this is haram, and thus forth and so on. Seeking a judgment in other than the Quran and the Sunnah, despite what the Quran and the Sunnah states or is pointing to. وَهُوَ الْمُرَادُ بِالطَّاغُوتِ هَاهُنَا. And that is what is intended by طاغوت here. Seeking judgments in anything outside of the text of the Quran and the Sunnah is seeking a judgment of ignorance and seeking judgments from that طاغوت. As Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala says, أَفَحُكْمُ الْجَاهِلِيَّ يَبْغُونَ وَمَنْ أَحْسَنُ مِنَ اللَّهِ حُكْمًا لِقَوْمٍ يُقِنُونَ. Is it the judgments of ignorance that they desire? And who is more better in judgment than Allah for our people to have certainty? And he have certainty in the next life. Is it the judgment of the majority that people seek? The judgment of the farmer who's never studied Islam? Or the doctor who hasn't put forth any efforts in learning Islam? Or the engineer who hasn't put forth any efforts in learning Islam? And thus forth and so on? Is it their judgment that you seek? These are the judgments of ignorance if they clash with the texts of the Quran and the Sunnah. And Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, He states, أَفَتُؤْمِنُونَ بِبَعْدِ الْكِتَابِ وَتَكْفُرُونَ بِبَعْدِ فَمَا جَزَاءُ مَنْ يَفْعَلُ ذَلِكَ مِنْكُمْ إِلَّا خِزْيٌ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَيَوْمُ الْقِيَامَةِ يُرَدُّونَ إِلَى أَشَدِّ الْعَذَابِ. Do you believe in some parts of the book and disbelieve in other parts? And what is the reward for the likes of those that would do such except disgrace in this worldly life? And in the next life, they will be brought to a severe torment. They will be brought to a severe torment. Ikhwat al-Islam ya ibadallah, it sickens me every time there is a discussion, regardless of what it may be about, concerning Islam. And the people use as a hujjah the majority to do, or the majority say, billions of Muslims are doing this, tens of thousands of Muslims are doing this. And they use that as a means to conflict with clear ayat and the hadith. But the majority of Muslims are doing it in locality or throughout the world is not a hujjah with us. It is not a proof in Islam. The proof is the text of the Quran and the Sunnah. So whenever we differ in our affair, this being halal, this being haram, and thus forth and so on, then the return is to the text and not to the opinions of the majority. As Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala says, وَمَا اخْتَلَفْتُمْ فِيهِ مِنْ شَيْءٍ فَحُكْمُهُ إِلَى اللَّهِ. If you all differ in an affair, then the decision is with Allah. And Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala says, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمِنُوا أَطِيعُوا اللَّهَ وَأَطِيعُوا الرَّسُولَ وَأُولِي الْأَمْرِ مِنْكُمْ. O you who believe, addressing the believers, obey Allah and obey the messenger and those in authority over you. فَإِن تَنَازَعْتُمْ فِي شَيْءٍ فَرُدُّوهُ إِلَى اللَّهِ وَالرَّسُولِ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُؤْمِنُونَ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ ذَلِكَ خَيْرٌ وَأَحْسَنُ تَأْوِيلًا. And if you are different in an affair, then return it back to Allah and the Messenger. If you believe in Allah and the last day, if you believe in Allah and the last day, that is best and more suitable for final determination. That is best and more suitable for those that hope for paradise in the next life. And with that, subhanaka allahumma wa bihamdik, ashhadu an la ilaha illa ant, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk, wa aqimu salat.